Well, hey everybody, we have just finished up a lovely couple of days camping on, what's the name of the mountain again?
Tunnel Mountain.
Tunnel Mountain. And we've had a completely wonderful, lazy kind of segment of the trip. We spent quite a few days in Drumheller. We spent a few days here in Banff, which is God City if ever there was one. And now we're back on the road headed for Vancouver. So thanks for watching our episode so far. And our next stop, Vancouver. What are you looking at there, Leslie?
I'm looking at a bear. I have to say, I think it's maybe the second one I've ever seen on Lake Louise, like when we do this drive, although they say it's all the time. I don't recommend pulling over like this, but but what can you do? Just don't get out of your car.
Well, hi everybody and welcome. Have fun out there. It's currently in Field, which is about an hour outside of Banff.
And as you will see from our footage, as we continue into the Rockies get a lot more rugged and sheer and intense, I guess is a good word for them. Banff is such a beautiful place and the rest is beautiful, but it's different. Each mountain has its own feeling and I wish you could experience it as well as see it.
Yeah, if you ever get a chance to drive the stretch between Banff to Vancouver, I highly recommend it because the mountains take on such a different character every step of the way. And I, for one, am excited about this drive.
Me too.
Well, let's go. Well, not too bad. The one thing you start to learn how to do is tune the kids out. For the most part, they play pretty well. But every once in a while, they have a meltdown or don't share and fight and make noise. And you just kind of have to put a grin on your face and keep on driving. This is what I'm doing.
Boo, what's going on back here?
Okay, me and my sister are fighting.
Oh yeah, all smiles and chuckles now.
Yeah.
It's very frightening to go through in the winter time when the snow and the reason you're here for is avalanche.
Avalanche!
Hey babe, what you doing?
Well, we are taking a brief break here in Revelstoke Park at what's known as the Cedar Boardwalk. And you can see some giant cedars here. We've got one right over here actually. And we thought it would be a great spot to stop and make a sandwich.
It's a great way to cut down on costs by picnicking along the way.
Yeah, that's right.
And when you're following the Trans-Canada, there are lots of pull-out spots.
There are. And you get to have some healthy food instead of hamburgers and french fries every stop. How's lunch?
Good. We're in a fancy hotel. Haha, just kidding.
Say that again, Lucas. What are we at?
The ginormous tree sign.
Oh, that one's in French.
It is ginormous. Well, here we are walking in one of the first places that tell us that we're closer to Vancouver than ever before. As you can see all around us here, the forest is very much temperate rainforest, and that's how these large cedars can grow here. And it's absolutely lush. It's the lushest environment we've seen in the mountains so far, so let's keep going. Nice here, isn't it?
Rosa. Here is it. People are from the UK. top of Belgium.
So apparently at 8,600 kilometers, our family revolts against us. And the kids have been in the back seat for about 4 hours, complaining about things they've lost, things they want, ice cream that they wish they had. And we just want them to share a little bit with you. So Lucas, what is it you want?
Ice cream and vacuum.
Really? And didn't you just have ice cream?
Yes.
Oh, but you still want more? Yeah? And you want bakugans?
Yeah.
Yeah, they're all smiling.
And little Miss Armin, what's your gripe? Oh, really? Oh. How are your feet? They're okay?
Smell it.
All right. Mommy, any gripes?
It's getting a little longer in the car. TDI is like a sort of total drama.
What
does TBI stand for?
Total Drama Island.
Oh.
Yeah, it's all smiles and chuckles when the lens is on, eh?
Yeah, exactly.
Well,
what's your gripe?
My gripe is the numbness of my brain and my tongue, apparently. So we'll see you in Vancouver.
We'll see you at my...
Bye. Well, everybody, according to the GPS, we are 113 kilometers from the ocean, the second one that we've actually come out to see. So I think we're all ready. What do you think?
Yes.
You!
What do you think, Lucas? Well, I guess we'll save his joy.